only to be told that our luggage is either too big, too bulky, or too heavy. It is a controversial subject, and one in which Michael O'Leary, for instance, has no room for manoeuvre.
Well, we'll still allow you to carry 10 kilos on board entirely free of charge.
What sort of woman do you know could get by on 10 kilos? I leave us blokes out of it, but there's no woman in the world I know even knows what 10 kilos is.
That's probably true. 80% of our passengers now don't travel with a checked-in bag, and I don't see why those passengers should subsidise the other passengers who insist on bringing a checked-in bag. On Ryanair, if you don't check in the bag, you fly even cheaper, but we still allow you to bring a checked-in bag. It'll cost you 15 quid, although, frankly, we'd prefer if you didn't bring it.
I'm sure you would. That's Michael O'Leary talking to Eamon Holmes, telling him what the Ryanair philosophy is in no uncertain terms. Well, we have paid for a no-frills service, but is there any way around it? How can we possibly bring extra baggage on board without incurring an extra charge? One man may well provide the answer. His name is Andrew Gall. He is a business consultant and the inventor, could I call it that, of the Rufus Rue tunic. The Rufus Rue tunic. Andrew, good afternoon to you. Can you tell me all about the Rufus Rue tunic, please, and where it all began?
So, Derek, my wife's Irish and went back and forth to Westport, County Mayo, and that quite often, so... Yeah. Really, this came to me last summer while I was on flights and they're heading over to Knock. Just seeing the people in the queues for the budget airlines and that flying over, seeing all of their bags having to be measured, all of them having to be weighed, and then the embarrassment for tourists, elderly ladies, etc., mm-hmm. having to stuff their camera bags or handbags or just an extra item and that into their bags. And if they didn't do that, then they were being fined £40, or they were having to check extra bags in. So really, that was the thing that got my back up. And one Sunday afternoon, when the kids and the family were over in Westport, I was left in the UK, and I spent a day stitching together, out of parachute material, orange and white parachute material, a jacket with big pockets on it.
Yeah.
And the following weekend, I tried it on the flight and the over. No problem. The staff saw it and said, "Is that your jacket?" I said, "Yes." It looked a bit ridiculous, mine. And we tried that out. And then I came back and spoke to a couple of friends that, you know, who think I'm a bit crazy in that anyway. But we then got somebody to stitch together two other samples that were a little bit more elegant. And the three of us did a trip from Luton and Bristol, respectively, over to Dublin. Had a bit of a crack in that there, put together the plan and the idea, and then we set about finding somebody to actually design it properly, and we found a great young lady, Rebecca Morta, who's based at London College of Fashion, and she came up with the designer that we've got now, which has got two massive pockets, two large pockets, sort of chest pockets, and two smaller pockets of passport and keys. But really, it was designed to be very simple and light, so it packs up into a plastic bag, which is the same sort of size as you put your liquids in if mm-hmm. you're traveling with hand luggage. And you can use that bag for putting your liquids in after, so it's very reusable from that point of view. It packs up very small, and it's extremely strong. And people are really taking it on board now.